This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about row operations on the TI-83 and TI-84 calculators. So we're going to be dealing with matrices, and we'll learn how to swap, add, and multiply rows within a matrix. Okay, so the first operation we're going to do is swapping two rows in a matrix. On the calculator here, I've got a matrix displayed. It's matrix A, and it's a 3x3 square matrix. For this example, I want to swap rows 2 and 3 of that matrix. So what I'm going to do is go to the matrix menu. I get there by pressing second, then I go down 3 buttons to the X inverse button. Right above that, it says matrix. Press that. That gets me to the matrix menu. And I want to go to the math column. So I'll go over to the right one. And then what I want is at the bottom of that column. So an easy way to get there is to press the up button, which takes me to the bottom. And I want to go up to operation C, where it says row swap. So I'll press enter. Now I'm back at the main screen. And what I have to tell the calculator to do a row swap is the name of the matrix that I'm going to be working with, and then the numbers of the two rows that I want to swap. So I'll enter the name of the matrix, that's matrix A. I go back to the matrix menu. I'm in the names column, and I press 1 for matrix A. I have to put a comma after that. Everything in this list will be separated by commas. And then I want to swap rows 2 and 3. So I'll press 2. And a comma, and 3, close the parentheses, and press enter. And what I've got displayed here is the original matrix with the second and third rows swapped around. So instead of 7, 8, 9, and then 1, 2, 3, I've got 1, 2, 3, and then 7, 8, 9. Now, if I do another operation right now, this new matrix will be lost. If I want to save it, I've got to store it. So to show you how to do that, I'm going to press the store button. That says that we're taking the answer and storing it. I have to tell it what to store it as. I'm going to store it as another matrix. So in this case, I'm going to store it as matrix B. Now there's already something there in matrix B, but this will just overwrite it. So the calculator is saying that it's going to store the answer as matrix B. I'll press enter to tell it to go ahead. And there's matrix B. Okay, so for row swap, once again, what you're going to do is tell the calculator the name of the matrix. That's something we always do when we're dealing with matrices. And the names of the numbers of the two rows that we're going to swap. Okay, let's clear this, display the matrix again, matrix A. And go on and see about adding a row to another row. So once again, to get to this operation, I have to go to the matrix menu, go over to math, I'll press the up button, and what I want is this item D, row plus. Now to add a row to another row, I have to tell the computer, the calculator, the name of the matrix, the row I'm going to add, and the row I'm going to add it to. So this is matrix A. I need a comma after it. And I wanted to add row 1 to row 2. So I'll enter a 1 and a comma and a 2, close the parentheses and press enter. And what I've got now is row 2 has become the sum of the old rows 1 and 2. So I had a 4 and a 7, they added up to 11. 5 and 8 became 13, and 6 and 9 became 15. Notice the original row 1 has not changed. The only thing that's changed is row 2, the row that I added that first row onto. Okay, so once again, the procedure for this is to tell the calculator the name of the matrix, the row you're adding, and the row you're adding to. Okay, so I'm going to clear it again. Display matrix A. And Let's see about multiplying a row in a matrix. Go to the matrix menu, over to math, press up, and we want item E times row. So the input for this is the amount of times we're going to multiply a row. And in my example here, I want to multiply 3 times row 2. So it'll be the amount, there'll be a 3 here for the amount of times I'm going to multiply that row, then a comma. Then, of course, I've got to tell it the matrix name. So I'll go into the matrix menu. We're going to do this to matrix 1, or a comma again. And the row I'm multiplying is row 2. Close the parentheses, press enter, and the old row 2 was 7, 8, 9. For the new row 2, each of those numbers is multiplied by 3. So 3 times 7 is 21, 3 times 8 is 24, and 3 times 9 is 27. Okay, so to review the input for this operation, you start out with the multiplier, then the matrix name, and then the row that you want to multiply. Okay, let's go on to the last one. In this, we're going to once again multiply a row, but then we're going to add that to another row. So I'll clear the screen, display matrix 1, or A. You don't have to display the matrix first. I'm just doing it so we can compare what we start with and what the result is. I'm going to go to the matrix menu again, over to math. Press up, and the very bottom item in this, times row plus, is what we're looking for. So the format for this is, I have to once again tell the calculator the multiplier, how many times I'm going to multiply the row. Then the name of the matrix, the row I want to multiply, and then the row I want to add that product to. So I want to multiply 4 times, in matrix A, 4 times row 3, and I'm going to add that to row 2. So row 3 was 1, 2, 3. That hasn't changed. But then we multiplied each of those elements by 4. So 4 times 1 is 4. That got added to the 7 in row 2, and we got an 11. 4 times 2 is 8. That gets added to the 8 in row 2, and we get 16. And 4 times 3 is 12. That gets added to the 9 in row 2, and we get a 21. Okay? So again, the format for this is you have to tell the calculator the multiplier, the matrix name, the row you want to multiply, and then the row you want to add that product to. Okay, so that's row operations in TI-83 and 84 calculators. Take care. I'll see you next time.